Though, something is amiss on New Zealand streets and in public places. The public rubbish bin appears to be disappearing. While stats on rubbish bins are a bit hit and miss, it is known in public service circles that because of illegal dumping, public rubbish bins, strangely enough, create more rubbish as well as an unsightly mess.
Well, now one council, the Whangārei District Council, is owning its policy to ban the bin, removing about 100 bins from public areas.
There's something unusual about this beach, Ruakaka Beach near Whangārei. There are no rubbish bins. But this isn't some top-down push by a penny-pinching council. This has been requested by the locals. The good folk at Patawa South started this fad. They argued that bins, in a weird twist, cause more rubbish. The locals at Ruakaka followed suit. Then Waipu Cove. And now the council has banished 100 bins to the, well, dustbin of history.
Meanwhile, Christchurch has gone the complete opposite. In this confined area outside the new Margaret May playground, we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
The council's gone silly for sorting bins. Except there's a problem. No one is putting trash in the correct holes, and much of it, even the recycling, ends up in the tip. This bin itself is in the throes of an existential crisis. It has itself become rubbish. Meanwhile, Wellington has appeared to hit peak bin. The city has about 1,500 of them, but the council is now trialling a removal in parks and gardens. The beginnings of a bin purge, perhaps. But should the public bin disappear from history, our most northern New Zealanders can claim the title of being the first to ban the bin.
Grant Elsop from the Whangārei District Council is here. So, Grant, the concept is you take the bins away and the rubbish disappears. Is it working?
Yes, it is, Jeremy. Our council was very much into encouraging community involvement. And during the past, when the communities had come to us and said, look, you know, there's a big bin problem here, we need more bins. So we'd put more bins there, but that just generated more rubbish. So we'd put bigger bins there, but that just resulted in bigger rubbish items like vacuum cleaners. And so up to date, we have removed 70% of the beach's bins.
Grant, we've had some photos sent to us from a resident suggesting the opposite, that beachgoers in particular are just dumping rubbish anywhere they want.
I mean, we're never going to get rid of the people that are just lazy and don't care about the environment. We've got a lot of great people in our district that go around and pick up rubbish, clean different areas, the beaches, and the council's very proud of those people and we like working with those people. Unfortunately, we still get the litter bugs that will dump rubbish. We just try and keep on top of it as best as possible.
Thanks, Grant. Great to talk to you.
Thank you. Bye.
ASB and 7 Sharp, keeping you one step ahead.
It's a great idea. You go on the great walks, no rubbish bins. People take everything in, they take everything out. You take photos, you leave only footprints. It works well.
Yeah, but that's a great walk. You've got to walk miles in that situation. You're not taking much stuff with you. I mean, it takes a while to teach people not to take any rubbish to beaches, doesn't it?
Yeah, and well, just they can take it. They just need to carry it away in their chilli bins with them.